Open the door, get on the floor, everybody.
Hey, Sam. Two fish in a tank, and one turns to the other and says, "You man the guns, I'll drive."
And hurry up. Make it worthwhile. Oh. You're right. I taught you this game.
Open the door, get on the floor, everybody. Well, I'd suggest we walk the dinosaur, but it's a logistical nightmare, and I'll have no part of it. This week in Highlighting Minority Content Creators, I'm encouraging you to go and check out Big Bad Kaiju on Twitch. That's big_bad_kaiju. They're a non-binary game streamer who is dedicated to providing a safe space to encourage a feeling of community and helping to develop positive mental health practices. They encourage open discussions about the sorts of games that people play and the insights that this can give us into who we are. They play a really interesting range of games and are building such a wonderful community. You'll find a link to their channel in the description.
I don't know about you, but I find the sound of church bells really appealing. Appeal.
Open the door, get on the floor. Everybody, put your hands behind your head and stay away from the vault. Get on the floor. Everybody be cool. This is a robbery. Any of you... Wait, we can't use that? What? Oh, swearing. Okay, We ran a poll asking which mineral out of bismuth, fluorite, uvarovite, and crocoite you thought was the kindest, and the majority of you went with bismuth. You made the right choice. Bismuth is obviously the friendliest. Have you ever heard of a chunk of uvarovite having compassion? Not like a warm, loving rainbow slab of bismuth. That's a mineral you can count on. Today I'm going to learn you how to make Japanese-style fried rice, or yakimeshi. As far as Japanese food goes, this is one of those dishes that was brought to the country by the Chinese, but that Japanese chefs infused with their own flavors and food styles. I might teach you how to make Chinese or Yangzhou fried rice one day, if you ask nicely. As pre-prep for this recipe, you need to cook and cool to room temperature 2 cups of Japanese sushi rice, or if you can't find that, medium grain rice. That's 2 rice cooker cups of uncooked rice, by the way, not 2 cups of cooked rice, and definitely not 2 measuring cups of rice, which is way too much. This recipe serves 4, not 40. First up, we're going to prep some vegetables. You can use whatever veggies you like, really, but I'm using carrot, capsicum, and longer and onions. Peas also work quite well. The most important thing for this dish is that everything is finely diced to roughly the same size. This isn't just for aesthetic purposes, although we do eat with our eyes first, but also because fried rice is a very quick cooking dish, and if everything is the same size, it will ensure consistent cooking. And because the nature of how we eat fried rice, by shoveling it into our mouths all mixed together, means you don't want to be dealing with any large chunks of vegetable matter. Everything should be roughly the size of a pea. You'll also need to dice a handful of middle bacon, or buy diced bacon like I did, because you love yourself and you don't have time for that. And also loosely whisk 4 eggs together. I'm not showing you that, because I forgot to film it. Next, put the cooled rice into a mixing bowl and stir through 4 tablespoons of kewpie or Japanese-style mayo. This isn't entirely necessary, but it does help stop the grains from clumping together so much. You cannot substitute regular mayo here, because the flavour of Japanese-style mayo is different. But if you can't find kewpie mayo, you can skip this step. Now, heat the oil of your choice over medium-high heat in a wok or frying pan. I use rice bran oil because it has a very high smoke point, is neutrally flavoured, and it's pretty cheap. Once the oil is hot, add the rice and stir fry it for a few minutes, trying to separate the grains as much as possible. After a few minutes of stir frying, push the rice to one side and pour the whisked eggs into the empty space. Mix them round themselves until they're about 1/4 or 1/2 set, and then quickly force them into the rice. This gives you a mix of golden egg-coated rice grains and little chunks of fake omelette throughout the dish. Now we add the veggies and bacon in the order of how long it takes them to cook, continuing to stir fry between each addition. This happens quite quickly, and the timing is something you need to practice, but remember, crunchy is better than soft, because you want textural elements to what you cook. Also, if you can't eat bacon for religious or ethical reasons, you can use whatever meat you like, as long as it's finely diced, and if you don't eat meat at all, you can just add another vegetable. Finally, season with salt and pepper, stir fry one last time, show off a little if you like, and serve. Any leftovers can be kept for a day or so in the fridge, and if you really want, you can halve the amount of everything to make two serves instead. If you cook this, upload it to Twitter and show me. Open the door, get on the floor, everybody stop, drop, roll! Ah!